Okay, so we're going to talk about WordPress. WordPress is a tool that you can use to create websites. It's pretty easy to use. It works with templates and with themes, so it's pretty straightforward. You don't have to know how to code or anything like that, which is good. So the first thing we're going to do is go into WordPress.com. There's another website that's WordPress.org that's a bigger version of this, but in order to use that, you have to have a host and a user and a domain, and those cost money. And it's bigger, so it's a lot nicer. So if you're interested in that, that's a good thing to do. But this one is pretty, just a smaller version of this. So once you're on WordPress.com, you're going to go on to get started, and it's going to help you set up an account. And so this lets you do blogs or websites. We're going to do websites. And then there's all these themes that you can choose to set it up. And we're not going to worry about that now. We're going to come back to that later. So you need to choose a name for your site. I'm going to choose Skippy. And it's going to assign me skippy908.wordpress.com. And I want this one that's free. And then I want this free plan. These are bigger ones we have. And then this is going to help you to create an account. So I have an account with them. So I'm just going to log in here, and log in, and then it's going to ask you to, it's going to send an email to your connection to your email you're going to have to click on, and then to activate your account. So anyway, what's that done? When that is done, this is what we wanted. This is the same thing we just did. This started with the website. We're going to skip the themes for now. This didn't create an account for me, so I'm going to do this again. My friend Skippy, and this is the one I want, the free one, and it's going to build a site for me, so it takes just a minute, and there we go. So now we're in to WordPress, so this is what the site looks like. This is the generic one with nothing on it, so we're going to change all this and add stuff. So you can see down here there's a button that says Customize. And this is going to pull up a menu that allows us to change things. This is the customized menu, which is the way it looks. So we've got all these different things. So start up, we're going to give it a title. So let's say one I was building was for a restaurant. So let's say this was for my, it's called Judy's Cafe. And then, so now it has a name there, you can see. And we're going to save and publish, so it'll keep the changes, and then we're going to go out of this for now. So this is now the website that we have. And we want to change it. So one thing I want to show you is these widgets. These widgets are kind of cool. They're tools that you can add into what's called sidebars. And the sidebars are down here towards the bottom. So there's lots of different things you can add. So this one has a text widget, which is just text that you put in. So I could put in some menu choices if I wanted here. I had a bunch of menu typed up. I could put that on there. And there it goes. And then it's on there. Where there's other things I could add from these widgets. So we could add a couple more. We could add music. We could add a list of blogs we follow. We could add pictures from Flickr or an image or an Instagram account or all of these different things. There's a calendar you can add from here. And there's links you can link to different things. You could add pictures or whatever you wanted to do. So there we go, let's put a calendar in. And just title it calendar. And so now there's a calendar. Or there's RSS feeds you can add. If you Google something like CNN RSS feeds, you can add them down here. Right there, RSS links, and you could put links, you could put highlights from CNN or whatever you want on there. I'm not sure how that would help with my website for my restaurant, but those are just there's lots more options. And if we did this one, if we did this contact info, So this is, let's say this is our contact info that we're in San Diego. This is our phone number and our hours. And it even added a map so you could be found. So I think that's kind of cool. You can put that all on the website. So it's saving it. We're going to get out of this section here. So here's our website again. So if we edit this, you can edit the different pages. So this is my, so if I put something in here, I could put, change this to say welcome. And then I can add things. I can add media. So let's say I had an image I wanted to add. So I would upload this. My image is right here. So I'm going to add a picture. This is a picture I found of a Denver omelet. So then we could say that very special is a Denver omelet. Let's say, oops, say it's 8.95. Oops. So now I have a picture that I put onto my site, and if I update it, that'll put that on there. If I click on right here, it'll let me put more posts. And if I go out of here, so these are my pages. This is my, and if I click on themes, let's look at this one more time. So these are all these themes that we can add. So let's just look at the free ones. Some of them cost money, and I'm going to find one that I think will work for what I'm trying to do. So you can look at the different things, and then if you click on info, it'll tell you kind of a little bit about them. And then if you click activate this design, so it just added a theme for me, which is pretty cool. So now it has this background and this fonts and this structure, which is nice. So it put my widgets along the side. It's got this, and then all this stuff on here, which is good. If I click on edit, you can edit the different features. So this is back into my site, my page. So let's just get out of there. And then go back here. So these are the pages that you have. These are my blog posts. This is my about page and then contact page. And then these are my themes. This is my sharing options. If I want to put this link to Twitter or Facebook or whatever. These are some different plugins that you can add. So this, I have Jetpack on there. Jetpack allows it to track, to count the visitors that come. You can add on all these things. You can see some of these are not available if you're doing the free version. If you do people, you can add people to work on your website. Domains, you can add domains, and then settings lets me change things. I could change the title, I could change this address, I could delete the whole thing from here. And then this button here lets me write more blogs, more pages. I can add more media. And this is the plan I have, and these are the stats, so I can look and see if anybody's visiting my site. And if I go back to this preview, you can preview it for a desktop or a tablet. If you look at that, that's kind of cool. How it would look if you had a tablet or on a phone, which is nice. So this is going to be my site. And there's also a feature right there for a help feature if you want help with different things. And so this is basically the way that you would set it up. So it's organized into sections. This is the ways that you change the way that it's the way that it looks with these published features. This is the personalized ones where you change the actual theme. And this is you change different configuration features about the website. So this is a nice thing for your assignment. You're going to be creating your own website, just a basic website of something like a restaurant web page, or a you could do your kid's soccer team or a sports page or something about yourself. If you had photography or something you wanted to display, you could put that on there. But this is a really nice tool. It's pretty easy to use. It's very popular. A lot of companies use it. So it's a good choice. So there you go. Thanks for your time today, and hope you learned a little something about WordPress.